So let's take a look at the safflower seed. You can see it's just one uniform type of seed. It's just a little white seed. And we have this in a couple different feeders as well. One thing that's great about this is squirrels do not like this.
Hey everybody, Sean and Allison here from Spoken Garden.
Hi everybody, happy Wednesday to you. It's Wildlife Wednesday around here, and it's day 142 of the Quarantine Gardeners.
If you don't know, that's us, we're the Quarantine Gardeners, and this is our daily video log of us accomplishing projects around our garden while under quarantine.
And we're so happy you're here today, you guys. Thank you for watching. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below if you haven't yet, so you don't miss out on all our daily videos.
So guys, today, Wildlife Wednesday, we're gonna go over bird seed and what birds get attracted by different bird seeds.
Yeah, we have a lot of different stations of different types of seed around our yard, and they attract different types of birds. So that's helpful because you want to spread out those feeders so they're not all fighting over one feeder.
Yep. So guys, we wanted to show you the different bird seeds that attract different birds because you might want to attract different birds in your garden too. So we're going to show you what we use, and maybe that'll give you a good idea what you can use too.
Okay guys, so here is some bird seed that we use on a regular basis.
Now, you might be wondering like maybe why you wanna attract birds to your yard, because maybe they're a nuisance or they're too loud, but they're so much fun to watch. And Sean and I are kind of bird nerds a little bit, and we use this book a lot to identify birds in our region because we're in the Puget Sound. We mark a lot of pages of the different birds that show up, so that's a lot of fun for us.
It's a great book, you guys. It's really useful, helps us identify birds.
So we use that a lot. And we love attracting birds. It helps with pollination. It's part of a wildlife garden and just promoting a healthy ecosystem.
You can see in behind here off the book there, there's Wagner's safflower seed. And next to it, there's some Audubon Niger seed, a wild bird food seed. And this stuff works great for attracting all different kinds of birds year round for us too. I mean, we get birds all year throughout each season. And we get migratory birds, we get native birds. I mean, it's great.
It is fun. It's great to watch. So let's start with talking about some of the different types of seed we have out here. This, we don't have the bag out for you to see, but it's just a basic bird food blend of all different types of seed. These little white guys, this is white millet. There's two different types of sunflowers in here. There's some peanuts. I even found there's some cracked corn right there.
Oh, cool. Neat.
Now, the good news is this attracts a huge variety of birds, and we have at least two, maybe three stations set up with just that basic blend. The types of birds that this attracts is quite a variety, actually. In our yard, we see a variety of finches, like goldfinches, juncos, which are a type of finch. We see house finches, we see sparrows, we see chickadees, black-capped, and what's called chestnut-backed. We see both kinds, and these are year-round visitors. And that's really fun to watch. So we have at least three different stations where we have that kind of seed set up. So if you want to kind of, you want the biggest bang for your buck to get as many birds as possible, a blend would be a good idea for you. So let's take a look at the safflower seed.
You can see it's just one uniform type of seed. It's just a little white seed. And we have this in a couple different feeders as well.
One thing that's great about this is squirrels do not like this. So that's good to know.
Yeah, that's good. So more for the birds, because those, we haven't shown it yet, but the suet that we put out, the squirrels just love that. They take that and they just run with it. Literally, they'll pick it up and try and run with it back to the nest.
That is pretty funny. So safflower seed, also pretty much all the same birds from the previous list will show up and get into this seed. You'll also maybe see cardinals, which we don't have on the West Coast, at least in our area. So if you're looking to attract cardinals, safflower seed would be a really good idea. And this is called Niger seed, or also it just might be called thistle, a thistle type of seed. You can see it's just
tiny.
Tiny.
Wow.
And squirrels also do not like this, so that's good. Lots of different types of birds will come to this type of seed. So like we said earlier, it's basically the same list of juncos, goldfinches, house finches, chickadees. We also have brown creepers, which I think that name is hilarious. Mm-hmm. They will kind of forage through some of the seeds. One thing we haven't mentioned is we have a lot of birds that are not on those lists that actually forage off the ground. And they eat seed, they just don't get up in the feeders.
Or the squirrels will knock the seed down to the ground because they're really, really tidy that way. Not.
Yeah, they make a mess. Harried thrush, they usually forage around the yard and sometimes they'll eat the seed. Also spotted towhees, so that's kind of fun to watch because they're really interesting looking. Those are the three types of seed that we have available to show you and talk about, but there's one other option we want to point out. So this is called just like basically a woodpecker brick or woodpecker log. It's basically just a blend of bird seed, all the different types, just kind of like compacted together and heated into a little brick.
Like amalgamated together. It's kind of a weird thing, but they love it.
They love it.
Oh my gosh.
And you guys, for real, this attracts. We've seen at least four different types of woodpeckers in our yard. Mm-hmm. Downy, hairy woodpecker. We've seen northern flickers. We have a lot of those and they're huge.
Mm-hmm. Big bird.
They're really big. They try to hang from this thing and they're just giant.
They kind of almost tear it down.
They do, they're so big. Unfortunately, squirrels will go after this because there is sunflower in here, there's cracked corn and some other stuff that they like. So they will, you might have seen video that we've showed where they'll hang and eat off of this. But all different types of birds flock to this as well.
This is a big hit, you guys.
Yeah, you guys, we hope that was helpful just to kind of get an idea of what is out there. You may have seen all of these types of seed in the store or online and not known what they do or why you should have so many different types. But like we said, spreading out different feeders around your area, if you have room, is really helpful to avoid fighting, or they'll get kind of crazy at the bird feeder at feeding time. So it's nice to have different options for them to spread out.
Oh yeah. Yeah, there's a lot of competition, and even at the bird baths, you see them kind of squawking at each other. So having that stuff spread out makes a big difference.
It's super entertaining. And one big bonus, not only do we love watching and seeing who shows up, and again, like we said, we're nerdy, we kind of track it and keep, you know, tabs on who's who.
We name them.
We have a couple that we name in the yard because they show up every day. But I actually take pictures, and some of you know I'm into photography, and I just shot all the photos for our book coming up. And I love taking nature shots, and I kind of started taking bird shots. They were really fun and also very challenging because a lot of times they're moving around so fast. So I love the action shots.
Yep, she does a great job, everybody.
Working on it, thank you.
So guys, leave your comments and questions down below for us. We love hearing from you guys. Give us that thumbs up, let us know we're doing a good job, and subscribe to our channel so you get updates on our latest videos.
And that's a wrap for our Wildlife Wednesday for today. So we'll be back tomorrow with another new project, you guys. So come on back and see what we're up to, and we'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow, everybody.
Bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.